Guest Squad, welcome back to my channel. This is Cecily, as always, and today is just a little bit of an update video. So I am so sorry for my absence from social media and posting last week. I try to post at least twice a week, but last week was not one of those weeks because I had pretty severe pain. I had what we think was a partial obstruction of the bowel, so part of my disease involves occasionally my intestines closing off slightly on their own. This is called an inussusception or a pseudo-obstruction. And typically, there's not really anything surgically that you can do to fix them. They just have to resolve themselves because it's not a food blockage. It's not food that's blocking your bowel. It's that the bowel sort of telescopes in on itself and makes it impossible to carry food through the alimentary tract. So, I was definitely in a lot of pain. It was a tough week. It was a lot of just like writhing around in my bed and like praying that the next dose of medication was finally ready for me. Now, I will say that normally in this situation, I would go to the ER or a hospital. And I think that that's really important to do when you're having just horrible bowel pain, because typically that means that something's gone very, very wrong. But this time around, I really tried to avoid going to the hospital only because we are in such a dire time in terms of hospital occupancy and everything along those lines. And I just felt like it was important to triage myself and say, is this something I can handle at home, or is this something that I need to go to the hospital for? Now, I was about like one day from going to the hospital. I was very close, but then my symptoms started to turn around and I started to feel much better over the weekend. So I'm finally back, I'm feeling better. It's just been kind of a difficult week for me in general, and when I'm feeling sick, I don't know about you guys, but I tend to just close off to the rest of the world. I close my door, I lay by myself, I don't pick up my phone, I don't do any of that. So I am sorry about my absence over the past week, but this is just part of being sick, is that some weeks are just much better and some weeks are much worse. So I'm hoping that this upcoming week is gonna be one of the better weeks. But yeah, please like tell me in the comments below if you guys have had weeks like that where you just lose 7 days because of pain. I know people with Crohn's and UC often have flare-ups that just send them into the lowest depths of hell sometimes, and I can definitely relate to you all. It's really tough when something just happens out of your control, out of the blue. I couldn't think of anything I'd done to cause the blockage. I think that's part of why it's so scary for me, because if I could say, oh, like I ate something that was really not good for me, okay, then don't eat that again, and I won't be in pain. But as with, you know, you Crohn's and UC patients, sometimes you don't even do anything wrong. It just, your body just decides to rebel against you a little bit. So I had to take a week off. I had to take care of myself and try to do the best I could at hospitalizing myself at home. My boyfriend was really helpful, and my cats, as always, were giving me lots of therapy snuggles. So I did get through it. I'm feeling much better, but I just wanted to give you guys a very brief update about why I've been gone. And you'll probably see this makeup look in another video because I'm definitely going to be filming more for you all today. But yeah, so just leave in the comments below if you've had these kinds of weeks. I'm sure you all have. I can't be the only one. So I'd love to hear about it, and I did miss you guys a lot. Thank you to those of you who were concerned. I really appreciate that. I am doing much, much better, and I will let you guys know in the future if I have more of these flare-ups. But I appreciate all of your care, and I love you guys, and I will talk to you in my next video, which should be out very, very soon. Bye, Gut Squad!